New at 6, crisis in the Keys. An infestation of something called screwworm is killing endangered deer, and there are concerns it could be spreading. We want to warn you, some pictures that we're about to show you may be tough to look at. CBS4's Hank Tester live in Key Largo with what's being done about this problem. Hank.
Well, here's what's being done that you're going to run into right now. This is a check station here in Key Largo. Traveling with or transporting an animal, you have to stop. Agriculture agents are here, and so is a vet. Let's take a look.
Roxy.
This is Roxy.
Yeah, this is Roxy.
Hi, Roxy.
This is JJ and Muffin.
And they're fine. They passed inspection.
They passed inspection.
All dogs, all animals coming out of the Florida Keys getting the once-over from state agricultural officers. Looking for signs of screwworm infection spread by flies like this, attracted to animal wounds. Eggs are laid, worms hatch inside the wound, devastating infection follows. Key deer, the miniature deer that thrive in the lower Keys, most vulnerable. Monroe County Sheriff Rick Ramsey's deputies get the calls about sick key deer.
You see the top of the key deer's head just like a bowl shape, like someone carved it out. You can tell it's suffering, it's wandering, it's crashing in the walls. It just breaks your heart. It's so sad.
The tiny deer, tourist favorites, and only found in this part of the world, usually discovered with the infection after it's way too late. 60 dead already. The task, keep the screwworm spread isolated to the Keys. That's why this interdiction station is set up in Key Largo. The next move includes
the release of male screwworm flies that have been sterilized. They are not modified or engineered in any way other than to be sterilized.
The flies mate but produce no eggs.
And the paper also mentioned that there'd be a check station.
And for good reason. If the screwworm spreads to Florida's cattle industry, the state would face economic disaster.
And it certainly could impact the rest of the state by quarantine if, in fact, it spreads into the remainder of Florida.
Well, you have to remember that the state of Florida is second in the nation as far as beef production. That's why measures like this are critical for Florida. I'm Hank Tester, CBS 4 News. Back to you.